Now Gordon around the horn to Jokic. And Jokic tips it in. So the big tipper getting some work here early. Scott. Nuggets 5-2 lead. Now long range three is no good. And Jokic hustles out of the backcourt. Jokic on his horse. Jokic in deep. And he drops it up and in. Now Wimpy has it knocked away. Now Gordon's got it. Down the middle to Jokic. And he puts it away with the slam dunk. Timeout pop. Got the only 40-20 game, as Scott mentioned. Inside, off the rim, no good. And Jokic there with a follow.
He thought he got slapped on the follow.
Jokic is out on the break. Here he comes. Oh, he rams it home. Take that.
They tried to soft layup the time before, and he didn't mess around that one.
You're going to try to block this one, you're going to have to get it quicker.
Well, Jokic, 10 points. Champagne. And threw it away. Jokic right there. Porter for three. Got it. Blake Wesley and Zach Collins have come on for the Spurs. Now wide open is Brown. And he knocks it in. Well, Christian Brown is having a sensational march. Sixth-year man from Gonzaga, 27 starts, 35 games off the bench. Back cut. Oh, my gosh! Can I get a hallelujah? Three dunks for Nikola Jokic in the first quarter. Jokic, 12 points, 8 rebounds, 2 assists.
He wants to make that three, though.
Jokic, three. Got it! Nikola Jokic.
Now, all of a sudden, the first unit's kind of coming in and playing down to it as well.
Biggest lead of the evening for the Spurs. Jokic with a little floater, that's good. 54-53, Wimby, no, Porter's got it. Oh, and it's deflected, goes to Jokic, and he drops it in. Nuggets ending on a 14-6 run. Now Jokic on the move. Missed it. Put it up and in. Boy, he's got such quick reaction. Jokic, scoop it up and in on the backhand and a foul.
Protect himself. It was right by Wimby. There's the reach and the foul. But see, now he gets away from it. And again, the pass in the center, or into the post, and everybody stands.
Jokic going to work, wheels into the key, drops it in. 25 for Jokic. Jokic thinking about the three. Now he attacks. Comes floater over the top. He's got to create some distance to get away from Wimby, and did. Jokic eyeballing, dump it in. Who scores? What a lead pass! Until Gordon came flying. Jokic backing in. Puts it up and in. Look, he's got the softest touch in the NBA. Anything that hits the rim. Caldwell Pope, give it to Jokic. Put it up and in, and a foul. And Nikola Jokic will head to the line.
Good, but you take. So now Collins comes over the last second, but now his body's, as he comes back, is just going to go right into Nikola. But it's because of that penetration by Collins.
Nuggets were up 99-88, just under 8 minutes to go. Christian Brown in the lane, no. Jokic follows it up, and Wemby's hurt. Jokic has it. They missed him on the post. Now he's got it. Put it up and in. Well, that's a nice out-of-bounds play by the Denver Nuggets. Gordon, will he take the three?
He didn't want it.
He's better in the right corner. Not as good in the left corner. Jokic in the lane. Good!
Because people are wondering when the shoe is going to drop, but this team continues to win because of the young player as Embiid gets his first basket to go. Points in the paint, 29. That's all correlation because of how much attention as Embiid he garners. Anytime he touches the ball, all eyes are on him.
As we play here the final half minute in this opening quarter. Embiid the handoff to Hield as those two play the two-man game. And Hield, Cash Money with that mid-range J. Without SGA and Jalen Williams, this is the other Jalen Williams, not that time. Three chances and they come up empty. Embiid posting up. He was fronted, and he makes it look easy. It's interesting. Even at full strength, as you mentioned, Reggie, they change lineups, starting lineups, their rotations in game. Sometimes they're – and Jalen Williams, their number two scorer, showing you just how deep and efficient this team is. Embiid, top of the key, Jay, cash money. OKC taking over sole possession of first place in the West with Denver and Minnesota right on their heels. That is Embiid. Again, they're the number one three-point shooting team in the country at better than 39%. Harris. Half-game lead over Denver and a one-game lead over Minnesota. Good interior defense with Embiid there and the loose ball corralled by Payne.
Remember, Chet Holmgren had 8 of the first Thunder's 14 points, but hasn't scored since. Another block shot here on the evening for the Thunder.
Kenrich Williams, another undrafted piece. Harris corner three, that's good.
And these guys just can't come into the gym and just have practice threes.
Well, it's a tough bounce pass. Embiid, little kind of scoop bounce underneath to Batum for a beautiful pass as they find Batum. But you saw Englund, the shot doctor who has worked with so many franchises over the years. North Philly native. Joined his hometown team after the buyout with Charlotte.
There it is.
There is Embiid, and we are tied. North Philly native. Join his hometown team after the buyout with Charlotte.
There it is.
Embiid. As they avoid the turnover, this is Giddey. Crosses over. Look at Embiid. A foot race with Holmgren backed contact. And Embiid headed back to the free throw line.
Who has lost 13 games in a row. Lob under to Davis. That's the way to start the game as he lays it up and in. Discrepancy, 23 free throws for the Lakers and just 2 for Toronto in the fourth quarter. LeBron all the way, the backhand layup is good.
The assist.
12-4. It's completely different than the other night when the Lakers were out of the gate so quickly against Brooklyn as
easy deuces.
Cutting down the middle. That's good feed by Reeves. Just finding space right in the middle of the lane was AD.
Has 8 to lead all scorers.
D'Lo right in front of us. Good pass underneath, and Davis is making his presence known with yet another slam.
Stretch. They're just 35%, 26th in the NBA.
You talked about the Raptors.
They're pretty good points in the paint. 4th in the NBA. Lakers are 2nd. D'Angelo, nothing but net.
AD and LeBron, 17 feet. Lob under to Davis.
The lob and the jam.
That's going to be so easy tonight.
Miss taken. Lakers. Here's LeBron, the middleman. Stutter step all the way. Backhand layup. Pretty stuff.
Lenny steps out and he just throws it up, and then LeBron just navigates.
He was the defensive player of the year in college in the American East. That might tell you something. He came in as a defensive stalwart. D'Lo bumping into Liberty. James with a left-handed dribble goes right around Olynyk. Reverse layup is good.
Drawing contact. We get a look at LeBron taking it to the rim himself.
D'Lo quickly. A touch it to the corner. Get a little ball fake by TP. He had the defender swiveling the other way.
And then the drive and kick by Torian Prince for D'Angelo.
Backing it up is LeBron, orchestrating this time down the floor. Hayes with the pick. You got a Raptor on the ground, and LeBron scoring the basket. Another, LeBron going to the rim. He scoops it up, and in, boy, he had a pep in his step.
It's been a real issue for the Lakers as of late, despite the fact that they're winning these games.
James is underneath, boy. He's taking it on himself to carry them here in the quarter.
Again, high fly axe. Watch this little fake. Whoop! There they go. LeBron makes them pay when they're off their feet. Three-point opportunity. He had 2 guys up off the floor. No box out.
Rockchalk, Jayhawk from Kansas. Grady Dick. LeBron lobbing. Laying in to AD. The chemistry between the two stars. Now his 11th season in the NBA. Kelly Olynyk.
They're going to leave AD alone, which means he's going to make them pay.
Outscored the Lakers in the paint. Surprising.
No look again. Davis down the middle he goes. Count it. Nice look by D'Lo and LeBron.
Full attention. And as you see, D'Angelo with the nice, pretty much no-look pass to the diving Anthony Davis for a three-point opportunity.
Here in the quarter. Davis handoff to D'Angelo. D'Angelo, that's going to be up. Oh, follow it up. One-hand jam.
Another look at the play where Anthony Davis rolled to the rim. Didn't get the lob, but got the second chance as he just easily threw it.
Situation again. LeBron, boy, he loves his matchup with Brown, who had no chance.
Just not big
Zero
enough.
Chance.
Yeah, just not big enough. Because Bruce Brown, he's a good defender around the perimeters and stuff, but when you put him on a guy the size of LeBron, there's really very little he can do that close to the basket.
Now to LeBron, so going cold at Toronto, they're giving him every opportunity. LeBron, yes! Right up and in, and he'll get a free throw.
Just a bit at the end, and Olynyk didn't get in position, picks up the foul, three-point opportunity, as the Raptors want to talk it over. With 7:41 to go here in the third, the Lakers have opened up yet another.
He's averaging 17 with the Raptors, averaged 15 with the Knicks.
Here's your three-pointer.
Finally, knock it down. LBJ.
So he obliged you with the corner three and nothing but bottom for the efficiency
in that department. And now they've got their biggest lead of the game at 16. And it's going to be 18 and almost 19 if AD can find a free throw.
Law of averages.
AD at an 81.5%.
Yeah, when you're that good of a free throw shooter, not a very thin
basketball. That is another turnover. The 10 for Toronto. Lob it underneath to Davis. Lob it underneath. Say it again. Are they too small?
way too small.
They're too small.
Anthony Davis scored the basket, and then he got into the passing lane, and the guy stepped in bounds. Really low.
Russell with 7 to shoot. Well, he finds an open shot. He's going to take it. D'Lo for 3. In Toronto. Oh, he's back. Here's the ball in the corner. Dinwiddie nearly falling out of bounds. Tapped by Jackson Hayes. LeBron hangs in the air. He's got another basket.
Just under the arm with the left hand of
Dinwiddie. Goes cross court to D'Lo. Fakes the shot. Wanders in. Now outside to LeBron. 6 to shoot. LeBron certainly knows it. And he finds a wide open D'Angelo. Perfectly done.
We've been quickly from getting the return pass as we see D'Angelo, the recipient of the camera, is slowed up and everything. So like, efficient, though.
Like Anderson, like Kyle Anderson, everything's slow. Here is D'Lo! Bring it up.
28 points, which is a game high, but D'Angelo's heating up from behind the arc.
He's made for the Lake Show. Weak side rebound, Rui. 29 for the Laker bench, outscoring it 29-7. Now to D'Lo on its way again!
Two out of his last three. I mean, you're talking about catching.
Dale with Chapinos.
Good help by Dinwiddie.
Here's Rui. Rui. Oh, I thought he was going to try a hook shot. Instead, it's D'Lo again. That arm's not going to get tired, folks.
Career high 15 points per game, having a career year from three. Rozier breaks three. Terry Rozier finds his way to the bucket for his first group. No team has held an opponent under 100 points more than them. Rozier rings up a triple. But Terry Rozier bombs away for him. He's got a few Knick offensive rebounds of the quarter. They couldn't capitalize. Rozier on a keeper for three. Kaboom! Right choice for Scary Terry. DiVincenzo is down in the front court. He's okay, though. In the corner, it's Rozier. Here it comes. Kaboom! And a foul!
Well around the perimeter. Caleb skipping it across and gets Terry a good look in that comfy corner.
How about Terry Rozier, John? 3 out of 4 from downtown. He's got a chance at a four-point play. Inside Butler. Collides with Achiuwa. Rozier for 3. Yes! Fourth triple of the first half for Terry Rozier.
3 on it.
We'll see if that stands. Right now, McBride with 15 points. Miami up 10. Rozier again. Terry Rozier, one kaboom.
Look at the left hand. He loves this pullback move here where he can set his feet, create some space. Dante DiVincenzo.
Robinson, now Rozier, guarded tightly by McBride. Three on the shot clock for Robinson. Rozier fading left. Got it anyway. That kind of night for Terry Rozier. He is 6 for 7. McBride averages 8 points per game.
He's really filled in well with Brunson, not his typical scoring self. McBride has been good.
Terry Rozier, you know he's doing right now. He's feeling himself.
Creation, his ability off the dribble and the sidestep here again. Look at the beautiful footwork. I mentioned him love going.
Seven starts, he's doing it again. Heat ahead by 11. Rozier against McBride. With under 4 minutes left in the third. Step back three. Yes! Terry Rozier continues his three-point barrage.
Footwork again by Terry Rozier. It's going to be a sidestep. Instead of left, he's going right. He's got some versatility, that man, to create openings for his shot.
Shot clock at 5. This is going to be tough. Rozier, a contested 3. Got it! Oh, my! Miraculous shot, a 3 for number 2.
Struggling in the previous 9 or 10 games, I want to say, from beyond the arc. And little crushed legs and some rehab and recovery.
Oh, look at the finish.
So, you know, the NBA adjusted the rules, and now we don't have that problem.
You're right about that. There's Davion. Nice little pass to Domas with the finish. Sabonis, that's his.
Because they've started knocking down those threes.
See if the Kings can get a bucket. Domas, nice quick move. How important is Domas in terms of going quickly sometimes on the offensive end? Domas, another rebound, his 12. Here come the Kings, looking to push the pace. HB, corner three, no. Oh, nice touch pass. That's how you find the big fella in Domantas Sabonis.
It's been super consistent for them in this game, 3 of 4 from downtown.
Yes, 17 points now for Norman Powell. Domas, that foul line jumper. It's going to be there, Katie. And once again, decisive with that, just the 7th turnover for the Kings. Oh, Powell got caught up. It's sloppy right now. Murray, oh! He got him! Next whistle. Here's Davion. Oh, getting to the paint. Nice find on the inside. Domas doing his Moses Malone impersonation. Sabonis, yes, his 15th rebound. Murray snaking that baseline. Nice little two-man game. And the Kings are just working over this Clippers defense. Look at this. 3 games.
Yeah, it's been one of those situations for him where he kind of had started playing more post All-Star break, as well as PJ Tucker. That has changed.
Oh, Domas just knows. But Trey Lyles, he has been everywhere tonight. Look at that. Domas, another rebound. And Katie, you talked about the offensive glass. Quality big, no doubt. Barnes, clock at 0. No. Domas, yes. He is just a 22.
3. Going in Brooks, and it bounces through. Brooks nearly stripped, got it back, finds Morris. Now it's Reed on the baseline. 6 on the shot clock. Nas Reed, left hand. The 27. Nas Reed, left hand off glass.
Rudy can switch and cover.
Reed on the attack again. Another bucket. Reed over to J-Mac. 3 ball, corner pocket. Timeout Houston. In this second quarter by Minnesota, after only scoring 16 in the first period. Great hands by Anderson in the hands of Thompson, who's blocked.
J-Mac to Nas.
Reed, cash. Edwards over to J-Mac again. Off the heel. Rebound slow-mo. Into Reed off glass for 2. Reed wants 3. Got it.
he is put together. 14 in the game for him.
Nas Reed to the cup.
A 22-point night.
Reed, the answer. Cash!
Break opportunity for the Wolves, and Reed gives it up. Here's Edwards down the lane. The hammer! Look down below!
It's Exum, who's been scoring well, careening off bodies, lost it inside. Jackson Davis got it. Curry looking runaways, four in the air!
Offensively for the Warriors, and you can see the difference. The defense doesn't allow for Golden State to get anything easier. Boy, they needed that from Wiggins. Always want some size on him, especially when he's got to initiate a lot of the offense.
Wiggins worked around a couple of swiping Mavericks. He'll go the other way, whizzing for the Golden State Warriors. Green in the middle, spins Wiggins, three. Here come the Warriors, a game below 500 at home, but six games overall above 500 on the season. Wiggins finagling his way for two, but gets the rebound and taken away by Looney. Lajemski, Wiggins on the side, into Exum. Lajemski will put it in play, driving and feeding. It's Wiggins on the baseline. The winner will go.
Laser one inside to Mobley. Mobley works on a shorter man in Sexton. Outside it goes to LeVert. LeVert drives, stops, fires, and scores as Caris LeVert ties this game at two. Mobley sends one inside to Jared Allen, and Allen lays it in to give the Cavaliers a 4-2 lead.
Jared Allen just under the basket. Nice hands, good pass.
There's Caris LeVert with a steal as LeVert knocks it away. He'll alley-oop for Allen, and Allen crushes it home to give the Cavaliers a 6-2 lead.
The bread and butter this basketball team is defending. Caris LeVert is excellent into passing lanes. Not scoring points, it's defending and stopping.
6-4 Cavaliers, 2 minutes in. Evan Mobley burrows his way inside and gives the Cavaliers an 8-4 advantage. We'll find Kessler. Now it's Colin Sexton, who was picked by the Cavs 8th overall back in 2018. You know where Colin's going. That's right to the basket. Evan Mobley, however, says no as he swats that Sexton shot.
Great defensive play. You know Colin's going to attack. Evan Mobley throws that stuff out of there.
Collins, he has had 18 in the 127-106 loss to the Kings. It was a lot more competitive than the score indicated as Mobley tests his range and Evan Mobley knocks it down. Mobley finds an alley. He'll dump off to Allen. Allen got Kessler in the air. He'll sneak it off the window and in. And Will Hardy wants an early first quarter timeout. Here come the Cavs in transition. Garland has his head up. Mobley just ran the whole way. Garland took his time, hesitated, allowed the big man to get there. Sacramento 2 nights ago, the most he has ever hit in his career is once again out. Free reign down the middle. The Cavs have been drawing Kessler, Brad, out of that middle. As the Jazz have connected on 7 of their first 10. It's been a concern for the Cavs as Mobley works toward the basket. He lays it in through contact, and Mobley has a chance for the 3-point play. I'm thinking about GM Justin Zanuck here in Utah as he fights through some physical issues as here goes Caris LeVert to the basket right through Kyra Lewis.
The Cavaliers are doing a great job. Everything's downhill going to the basket. So you're going hard, playing well, and you're going to get fouls. If you're
Jordan Clarkson is still one of the premier bench scorers in the NBA.
Light it up.
Allen inside once again. What a start for Allen. He's a perfect 5-for-5. Garland had 3 of them. He'll find Strus in the corner. Finds the cutter. Barrel to the basket. Missed the shot. Allen plucks it away from Yurtseven and puts it up and in. Put this thing to bed early, but credit the Jazz. After the Cavs got up to a really nice start, the Cavs outscored the Jazz 40-25. Allen to the basket. That's what the Cavs are looking for to reestablish that big man game.
Beautiful basketball.
They hit the ball into the face of Sexton. Now it's LeVert. Inside to Mobley. Now to Allen. Puts it up. It's blocked by Yurtseven. Mobley gets it back. He floats. No, but Allen is there to crush it home. Mobley. Hands to Strus. Strus to the top of the key. Over the top to Mobley. And the Cavs make it look easy.
Cavs got to take advantage of it. We're a bigger basketball team, more experienced team by just a little bit. Got to play that one.
Yurtseven puts it up. That's rejected by Mobley. Certainly happy to have
yes.
Sam aboard. He's a DH and an outfielder. as Mobley to the basket. Mobley gets the roll, and man after your own heart, he let it in golf as well. But eventually it's Strus who squeezes it. Here's LeVert on the move. LeVert goes across the lane, finds the trailer, and Mobley thumps it home.
Wow.
Is spotlighted in our Duncan reward of the game.
That is absolutely fantastic. Drives to the right. You're anticipating that right-handed hook shot.
By the Jazz as here's Jared Allen. Back it goes to LeVert. Extra pass to Strus. Strus roars out of the corner. How about that bounce pass as he finds Evan Mobley?
Just chipping away at the interior paint of the Utah. Nice play here. Good little bounce pass. Drop pass by Max Strus.
Evan Mobley. Merrill and Niang make up the Cavalier five. Garland finds Allen. Allen makes a good catch, plays it off to Merrill, and Merrill makes no mistake.
Boy, that's give Jared Allen a lot of credit.
Merrill hit eight threes against the Jazz in Cleveland in December. Here's number five tonight.
Yeah, absolute bullet of a pass from Darius Garland to Jared Niang, using his body and strength.
Merrill inside to Morris. Morris shovels to Mobley. Mobley lays it up, and Mobley follows with a dunk.
Just dominant basketball by the Cavaliers.
Great. Mobley with the follow, and the Cavaliers on an 18-point lead. Here's LeVert from the Utah logo. Mobley works in toward Horton Tucker. He'll find Morris. Morris for three. Boy, good east-west ball movement. Horton Tucker skips one off to Sensabaugh.
Excellent defense.
Almost
excellent.
Walked and he threw it away.
Yeah, excellent defense by Max Strus. He came over to help from weak side and fired out real fast to Sensabaugh so he can get a good shot
Strus that you were talking about.
Yeah, he ends up stealing the basketball, but it's all started by him going weak side to help with Jarrett. And then he charged back out. And
meanwhile, for Doc Rivers, Milwaukee Bucks will deploy Patrick Beverley in that starting lineup for Damian Lillard. Chris Middleton, Giannis Antetokounmpo, Brook Lopez, and Malik Beasley.
You commit two to three bodies of Giannis, you're going to be dead to rights.
Nice slice cut there by Corey Kispert off the feed from Jordan Poole. Played his college ball at the University of Wisconsin. Here's Denny. Nice cut. Good assist there by Jordan Poole. Denny, free and clear for a layup.
I mean, this is the time to eat at the basket. No Brook Lopez, no Giannis. That means no shot blocking ability for the Milwaukee Bucks. Take advantage.
Gallinari trying to use his dribble bag, but there's Jared Butler in there fighting for the ball. Wizards with possession. Good pass by Davis to Denny. Nice contest there by Tristan, who's running the floor. Wise decision to pass to Kispert. Kispert with a Euro step. Bucket there by Corey Kispert.
Right now, the Wizards with a five-point lead.
Kispert comes back and goes off glass. He is right trying to show and go. Pass out to Kispert.
Yeah, that's what Jordan Poole is going to have to do.
Well, two-for-one action here for the Bucks. Blocked by Denny. Denny passes it out. Kispert, three, got it. Wizards with a four-point lead to start the third. Chris Miller, Drew Gooden, Megan McPeak. Washington with the possession to start the third. Good ball movement. Oh. Inside to Denny. Rocking the rim on Giannis. Rebound there by Gill. Here's Kispert. Can he stay hot? Yes. Doc Rivers is not happy.
Because he knows.
17 for Middleton, 16 for Antetokounmpo. No one else on Milwaukee's team has scored double figures. Denny, count it, and the bucket.
Denny had Middleton set up.
Denny, crossover layup, very nice.
Let's get Denny Avdija at the top of the key.
Bucks now with 23 assists on 28 made field goals.
Right there, Denny Avdija.
Look at Kispert beating the pack down. Jordan Poole playing the role of quarterback.
And that's after a made basket, Chris.
A little more than two to go. Amarui, good pass inside. Good cut by Kispert. Poole over in the corner to the aforementioned Avdija. Great decision finding Kispert on net.
And that's been the name of the game, Chris, offensively.